Clint and Rae, it is indeed an honor and a privilege to be here with you today and with your family and friends. Now, please take a moment to breathe. To breathe in the presence of God and begin to experience one of the definitions of eternity.
And whoever I turn around and see, I'm all married up. Oh my gosh, baby, you look beautiful. How did you walk 14 miles in this dress?
I can't wait to marry you.
Okay, let's do it today.
Okay.
Like, what are you doing then? Like an hour and a half?
And I can't wait to see your beautiful smile come down the aisle to me this afternoon. I know I said it before, but today is truly the best day of my life. At least it is the best day until the rest of our lives. I love you always and forever. I love you, BB. Oh, that's so good. Oh, I just love him so much.
It is my distinct pleasure to introduce for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Clinton Randolph Hodges. You may kiss your spouse.
That Clint and Rae drove off today, me and my dad brought it down from their farm. And when driving down, my dad was kind of being a little nostalgic and talking about their courtship. And you know, he was telling me about when they met and he proposed. I can imagine something kind of similar to what Clint said. He told my mother two things: I'll always love you, and I'll never be bored. And I can imagine Clint said, I'll always love you, and I'll always be late. And what best man speech would be complete without unsolicited advice of the only unmarried groomsman? To seek to understand each other. Not always agree, but understand. And stay true to yourself, because that's who you fell in love with in the first place.
Selfie. Please don't.